today is our dreaded day that we need to start drilling holes in by Felicia. A little nervous. We have been waiting for some packages to come in the mail to finish off our solar installation, and it has arrived. Let us show you what we have.
First thing we have is a battery switch. And what this is going to do is it's just going to disrupt the power going from the solar panels to the battery while we're charging it using the generator or shore power. So we need that. This thing is going to be where we drill the hole on the boat. We're going to put some glue on here and stick that to the back of the boat. And then on the bottom is where the wire is going to come through. It's going to make it waterproof. Need that. And then this.
This looks like a giant nose.
That's a big nose. I'm really excited about this. This is a high tech for me. So we currently monitor our battery with a needle. We are in analog still. This is a Bluetooth era. So what this does is this is kind of like a phone cable, or some kids won't understand that.
Yeah.
When phones used to have a cable, this is how you plugged it in. Maybe it's a Cat 5, whatever. Anyways, this just plugs into the bottom of the charge controller and you mount this anywhere you want. And what that does is it gives us all the vital battery information, the charging information, all of the stuff from the charge controller right on our app. Really excited about this.
Yeah.
All right, so those are our three things. We got a battery switch, we got the Bluetooth kind of data transmitter. I wonder what the word for this is. Bluetooth module. And then we have the big nose piece. Big nostrils. Hey Lisa, do you know why gorillas have big nostrils?
To smell out bananas?
Because they have big fingers. I'll run you through everything we got. 4200 fasteners, various glues, marine weld, super glue, removable Loctite, dielectric grease, zip tie, cable clamp, adhesive that you can just put down and hopefully zip tie. We have 50 feet of cable that needs to get drilled through the back of the boat and this, and then we have to run it through the bilge and then to the charge controller. And then along the way, we have to make sure the cable is secure all the way through. Can I take a nap now? I feel like I did a lot of work already. I'm kind of tired.
We're so close. So close.
In a week, my little brother's coming down for his birthday, and we want to have most of these projects wrapped up so all of our systems are functional and we can just focus on taking the coolest trip possible that the weather will allow us. Gonna put a brace on. Cool. One more time. Okay. 89 inches. Hey, what'd I say? We had a flag holder and the flag no longer works because the solar panels kind of match up with it. So this is gonna be our stern brace. So when we were in Home Depot, we looked at the Ryobi to see what size to get. We got a 6.5 inch blade. It needs a 5.5 inch blade, but we checked it with the one that was in the store. So, all right, that sucks. Problem is this is actually made for stainless steel and hard metals. This is the blade that came with the saw. It's just a cheap, rough carpentry blade meant for wood. It's really dull. That tip is actually missing the hardened carbide. You see that?
Hey, I do.
Each tooth has a hardened piece of metal where it makes contact, and it's just missing on the lot. So that's pretty cool, man. I got two cuts to make, one on stainless, one on aluminum. I think I'll get through the aluminum. I don't know about the stainless, but I need to make these cuts. I'm gonna try. What's the worst that could happen? Eyes and ears. Hey guys. Hey guys. Tried to apologize to the neighbors in advance. We can work with that. One more. This is a way harder metal though. Let's see. Okay. I already marked it last week, but triple check the measurement. Check. Not my best cut. Sorry about cutting, guys. That was the last one.
Hey.
Yeah, we just got in some parts we were waiting on, so now we can drill the hole, because right now it's all zip tied to the railings. Yeah, so we're gonna get the final bracing up and get all the wiring tight. Nice. Probably 2 days of work, but yeah, we'll get it done.
All right, cool.
Pretty stoked, cool. Man. What are you guys up to?
All the adult shit.
Errands.
Yeah. Nice.
Right on, guys.
Later.
Check y'all's later. Have fun.
Yeah.
Hardware, light pole holder. That's going to support our back of our panels.
Ooh, nice.
Working with aluminum metal, and the screws are stainless steel, so I'd like to avoid using different metals because of the galvanactic action that can happen when salt water or even fresh water hits it. So what we're going to do is we're going to use epoxy. I've removed the adhesive backing off of these and scuffed them up with sandpaper, and then I've scuffed up the bracket that I'm going to use with sandpaper. So they're all prepped. I just need to mix the two-part epoxy and then put it on the back and squish it in. And honestly, I don't know. Maybe a bolt would be better. We're gonna see how it holds. Ugh. All right, we have 5 minutes of work time. Where'd my popsicle stick go? It's a very important popsicle stick. Okay, come up top of me. So you can see, I drew some circles and kind of scuffed up the aluminum. I've used this epoxy a few times. The epoxy is very good, but when you're using anything that makes adhesion, anything that sticks to something, the adhesion is only as good as the contact with the surface. So if it's a really smooth surface, you have to scuff it up a little bit so it can get in the pores. I don't think we'll ever have to address this again, but we'll see. All right. So this is going to be facing up. It doesn't have to be pretty. By facing it up, I'm going to hide all the wires, and then I think it's going to be more secure. I'll be able to get a zip tie through. Oh no. Okay, use less. Popsicle stick is the move. So I showed these in our last video and a couple people asked us about them. These are called step bits. Step bits are designed to make a bigger diameter hole, to step it up in size. So you can see it actually has measurements on the inside there. I'm going to be doing this one and It's pretty important, so I've actually marked it in Sharpie where I want to stop.
I don't love this.
What are you trying to do here? Trying to straighten this up?
Yeah, we had to move this over a little bit. Screw those in, those are really tough to get to. So we're slowly getting the wiring cleaned up. My goal is to have all of the wiring tucked in by the time it's gonna run down here, and then into here or somewhere. So, getting the black wire sorted here. This is where they come together. My goal is to have this either like protected or hidden. Feels like that's the spot for it. What do you think, Lisa? Yeah, I mean, I'd like to have this. This would be a little bit more out of the way, but. Yeah, that's it for now. And then I think with this, we're gonna try to go inside here and then run that red over. Mm-hmm. Probably just try that now. Ultimately, what I want is I want the red wire to be protected, right? Cool. So it's gonna go just like this.
We are going to take these wires that we've got cleaned up a bit and run them back down to the stern where we'll be able to drill some holes and then get the wiring through the lattice, then under the bed, and through the floor or under the floor to the batteries where we have a switch that will be connected to the charge controller and from the charge controller to our batteries. Wish us luck. We gotta pull everything out of the lattice. It's gonna be fun, Matt. Look excited.
So this is the stern light. When they put the davit on, the thing that lifts the dinghy, the dinghy will block the stern light. So they have it extended to here. So this no longer works. There's already a hole going through the boat right here. I'm thinking, why drill a second hole if I can just piggyback on the hole that's already there? Yeah, so I think I'm gonna take this off. I'll keep this junction inside this.
Weather coming.
Yeah, check it out. That's crimped there. We don't like that. This looks like a mess. We're just gonna redo it off. So. So these are the connectors I use. These is a metal sleeve that you put wires in and you crimp, and that joins the wires. That's what this is. It's called a butt connector. These are one step up. This is called a butt connector, but the plastic casing right here, when heat is applied to it, it shrinks. So it will actually tighten up and form kind of a seal around the wire. So that's an upgraded version of this. This is kind of for cars. This is more for the marine environment. And then this is just heat shrink, straight up heat shrink. So that's gonna go once we apply heat to that, then we're going to put this on top of the entire seam and then tighten that down. This is my favorite part. Check it out. So that's the connection. Pretty tight, right? This is going to go over it. Put it in the middle here. This comes in like 2-to-1 or 3-to-1 shrinking ratio. Ta-da! Now that, to me, looks much better than this. The reason they had this is that's a quick disconnect so our dinghy davits can fold in. Because they're meant to be where you can pop them out and then pop them in, so I guess if you're docking or whatever. But because our solar panels are going over the davits and we're using that as a support, it makes no sense to have it be a quick disconnect. So it's kind of permanently wired in now. Time to drill a hole.
held my breath that entire time.
Why were you holding your breath?
Because I don't know, it was real fiberglass and that was pretty.
We've completed the wiring from the outside to the inside. So we got it running through the stern, through the lads, under our bed, through the engine compartment, and now to the charge controller. So we're just now be able to wire everything up and be able to put the battery switch in as well. We are installing the battery thermometer. The temperature sensor will help us monitor the temperature of the battery. Unfortunately, I purchased the incorrect Bluetooth module for our charge controller.
Ugh.
So it's back to the drawing board to find the correct one.
We're 2 weeks into the solar project and we're really tired. We could use a break. Luckily, we had some friends come out and spend the day with us, Anders and Destiny from Rat Cat Crew on YouTube. After hanging out for the day and working on a couple projects, we cruised over to our neighbor on Deja Vu. They hosted us for an amazing dinner party. We had fresh caught Ono and mac and cheese. It was a great night off, but now it's the next day and we're back to work. I'm sitting at the chart table. We've ran all the wires through the bilge. The boat is completely wired for solar. Now I just need to disrupt the wiring. So I'm gonna put this basic battery switch in somewhere right here at the charge table. So that way when we are charging on engine, we can turn the solar panels off. Should be easy enough, and this is our last thing to complete our project. So it's crunch time. My brother gets here in 2 days, and we have a week-long shakedown sail ahead of us. It looks like we're gonna have great weather, and we hope to make it all the way to Dry Tortugas. So stay tuned for that, we're really excited. Thank you so much for watching. Like, comment, and if you wanna support our channel, please go visit our Patreon page. Till next week, guys. Finishing up wiring, and our water delivery guys came. This is pretty cool.